With me this morning from Animoca Brands, I'm joined by Yat Siu. Yat, good morning. Good to see you.
Pleasure to be here.
Tell me a little bit more about your announcement this morning, Yat. This partnership here with Atari. Who are they?
Well, I mean, for those of you who are not familiar with the gaming world, Atari is a legendary gaming brand. Although it's gone through many iterations, we're very proud to announce the partnership with Atari, where their famous popular brands such as Pong or Centipede, we're going to be coming onto our Sandbox game, which is essentially a virtual land and sort of, I guess you could say, Minecraft-style game, but built on top of the blockchain.
And so what will be the objective of the partnership? What will the two of you be creating here?
Well, I mean, one of the things about buying and developing land on top of Sandbox is the ability to make games on top of that. So essentially, it's a kind of metaverse. So if you think about it, kind of like Ready Player One, for instance, where you can actually develop your real digital assets, that's kind of what Sandbox is about in a virtual land. And here, what Atari is doing is through the virtual land, they're basically developing an Atari world, you could say, on top of the Sandbox metaverse.
And when is the Sandbox launching officially?
Well, the Sandbox is due to launch this year. Obviously, I think the marketplace as well as the Creator Fund has already launched. So we're on our way very soon for a commercial launch for the Sandbox game.
And you had some news last week yet around your wholly owned subsidiary receiving an investment. This is $2 million. Tell us more.
So it relates to the Sandbox project as well, and we're very excited about that because although this was news that happened in 2019, we were able to announce it last week, which is basically Square Enix, which is one of the most famous game companies, I would say, at least in the gaming world, has announced investment into the Sandbox holding company, which is TSB. And the amazing thing about this is it's not just validation from a large gaming giant, but it's also very much a validation for the entire industry effort on true digital ownership. Square Enix is no light matter. They are the company behind Final Fantasy, one of the most famous games in the world. They also are the owners of Tomb Raider, again, a gaming franchise that you might have heard of. And Dragon Quest, amongst other things, and one of the most venerated game companies in the world. Having them support the Sandbox is, I think, is a great honor for all of us involved.
And in the lead up to the launch of the Sandbox, what kind of interest, what kind of buzz are you seeing around it?
Well, quite a bit. I mean, you have a whole bunch of creators that have basically created models and designs around this. And I think the thing that's worth reiterating in all this is that when people make these digital assets are permanent and they become real assets essentially because the blockchain makes them permanent. And so they can trade and sell them and of course use them in the game itself. And in this particular case, with the current launch, we've already had two land sales. And actually tomorrow, there's going to be the launch, or in the days to come, there's going to be the launch of the third land sale, where people can, and game developers, such as Atari, for instance, can buy more land to develop their content on top of the Sandbox.
And I suppose, yet with the unfortunate circumstance that we're seeing with the outbreak of coronavirus at the moment and more people having to work from home and being confined, are you expecting this to be, for want of a better word, advantageous for you?
Well, I mean, we certainly don't want to sort of sound like we're opportunistic here, but I think the reality is that we're in the virtual space and we're seeing definitely an increase in traffic. And we're definitely seeing, broadly speaking, from an industry standpoint, also more playtime and usage. But I think the part that is particularly exciting here, we have a lot of sports brands. One of the most famous ones in our stable is Formula One. And we recently, about maybe a few weeks ago, completed the sale of our Formula One crate items, selling close to $350,000 worth of these Formula One digital assets. And then these cars have also been trading in the secondary marketplace. So in that sense, it's just validation that more and more people are interested in trading and owning these digital cars that can then be used in a racing game. And very recently, Formula One actually conducted a virtual race with the actual drivers as well. Now, that's really interesting, because what that did was it actually caused the virtual racing itself to become mainstream, because everyone was watching virtual race, sort of a virtual Formula One race. And what that now did is make esports as a category and sort of gaming even more mainstream to people who may not have been exposed to that element of it, because it's now it's on sort of national TV, because it's Formula One. And MotoGP, which is another brand that we have a license with, is following suit as well. So I think the other thing that's interesting is that it's helping popularize these concepts, these virtual and digital concepts that may have been considered a bit more niche, but emerging very, very rapidly into something much sort of more mainstream in a rapid sense. And of course, you know, the other thing that we're seeing is, of course, extended game time, which is something the entire industry is seeing. So I think it is actually pretty good for our industry, but we certainly hope for a very speedy recovery on this one, although it does look like it might take a little longer.
Is there much more you can tell me about what your plans are with MotoGP?
Well, in our announcement, we spoke about that last year in MotoGP. What we have is similar to Formula One. We will be creating digital assets that we can then buy and sell and trade. But of course, there will also be a game related to that in which you can have utility to use these assets. Now, the important thing is both with Formula One and MotoGP, as well as the Sandbox, all the assets that are produced and then sold are actually owned by the players themselves. So even if you don't play that game, you will own it permanently. Let's say, you know, when you play games disappear after a while, maybe after 3 years because it doesn't make money or it wasn't a good game or people didn't like it, whatever reason, right? Everything and all your investment inside that game disappears. But with the way that we've approached it with blockchain, all the assets you purchase inside the game are yours forever. And you can use them in our game, or you can use them in another virtual environment, or you can trade them, or you can just treat it as collectibles. So I think that's the area where we differentiate very much from other game companies. So it's not just about the game, but it's about the assets themselves and the community that's building around it.
Very interesting. Yeah, nice to see you. Thanks for your time.
Thank you for having us.